So you can see here on these holes, there I'm just too close to this shoulder. You know, I can't get down here far enough without the chuck interfering. So in this case, what I do is I take an old Chinese drill bit. In this case, I'm taking a 9/16 and I just kind of ground it at something like that point. I mean, it's not perfect, but it makes a quick and dirty countersink to just get on with my work instead of just getting bogged down. So I got one more hole to drill here, and then I'm ready to bolt this guy back in place. Man, I am so close on this realignment, you know, the way I did it. I could probably thread these in, but, you know, it could just be a little bit of a burr. So all I'm going to do is just take my quarter inch and just touch it in here. That's not bad. That's not bad for alignment there. That's with my homemade countersink that I had to do because of this restricted area. Okay, well that's it. And now I'm gonna put the guide tube back on, the tubing back on, and that's it. I'm never gonna take it off again unless something catastrophic happens to my saw. Okay, so this thing is buttoned up tight. I mean, it's there. I got everything, all these bolted down, tight as can be. So I'm ready to pull this guy off. But what I'm gonna do is I see that I've got a little bit of sag over here on this side. And so while I've got this set up in here, I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna clamp it onto the other side and loosen my bolts up, probably put some fresh bolts in there and some bigger washers where it is kind of eaten into the wood and sunk down a little bit. But I'm just gonna clamp this and get it up, because I got this side just absolutely perfect, but I'm drooping a little bit over here. But, you know, while I've got this big, you know, 80-pound thing in here, I'm just going to take care of it. So this is all ready to get broken down now, and get out of my way. I'm sorry, Poppy. I'm sorry, that block scared you, didn't it? Want to come up here and help me while I'm doing this? Yeah. That'll get you. Yeah, you're helping, aren't you? Sure, a good helper. This thing has always been trouble, and really, I rarely ever use it. Watch out, Poppy. Let me tap on this. Oh, there you go. There you go. You stay there. It binds. It just binds in here so bad that I can't, you know. Okay, we're ready for final lockdown. We're just going to do a little snug. Then take these clamps off and then get the aluminum bar out and then do a final crank down. clean this rust off of this. It's been out of my lumber rack for a while. I hadn't used it in a while, and I can't let this thing get pitted and trashed. So I'm gonna clean this guy up here in a minute when I'm done with this. I'll just do a final tighten down on this and I'm done. I'm gonna fix the other side then. Well, this is just, you know, it's just taking me about 10 minutes to get this done. I just put my big straight edge bar on here, clamped it to the bottom of the cast iron webbing with a rapid, and now pulled this exactly flush in line, and this is all the way flush across the top of my table saw. And it's still right out there because that's where the prop legs were, so it wasn't able to drag. So here again, I ganged up, you know, three different size washers because that's what had happened. It had just sunk so far into that wood that it kind of lost its pressure and it just allowed it to slip. So I've got these four that I'm going to tighten down, and then I'm going to just go ahead and change these out here on the end too. But, you know, talk about a tune-up for my saw.
Well, I'm just living the dream today. That's all dialed in, just as flat and straight as can be. And now I'm going to put my box back in and clean up my mess over here. As I put all this stuff in and kind of put that away, then I'm going to be ready to get back to work. But this was a long time coming to fix that old bent Biesemeyer.
But I made this just in my standard way, where I rabbit the corners and screw down. And then I dadoed in for the, you know, I have, these are dadoed in, and then a stub dado. So, I mean, this thing, you drop it off a building and this thing wouldn't come apart because it's all just kind of locked together. And so it's a stout thing, and it's big. It doesn't look as big as it really is when it's snuggled up underneath that table saw, but that always really irritated me for years when I had that big open space and I had, you know, just decks of plywood and stuff down there. And I'd have just toolboxes and all kinds of junk piled down there with no real organization or access until I made this with these drawers. And so I think it's a pretty efficient use for a table saw setup. This just, you know, this just rides on that, the angle iron. It doesn't do anything. I have a board in there to help me get it in. I probably should have mobilized this saw before I tried to do this. Oh, I got a clamp under here. That's what it is. I still got a clamp for my assembly. That'll help. All there is to it. Now it's ready to put the drawers back in. And it doesn't have to be complicated. See, if you try to attach something like that and make it part of the whole integrated system, it just becomes complicated. You know, you can't really pull it out for maintenance or for cleaning. But this is done. Okay, well, let me put all my stuff back in and get back to work. Yo.